Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and I am back with another video, how to create project in GitHub. In previous video, we have seen how to create organization in GitHub. So we will continue and will create project in an organization. So let's start. I am connected with my GitHub account. Click on Manage Organization. Currently, I have one organization. Let's click on it. At this point, I don't have any project in my organization. So let's create a project in our organization. Click on Projects. With Project, you can manage work directly from your GitHub repository. So let's create a new project. Give the project board name. So what is the project board? Basically, project board on GitHub help you to organize and manage your work. You can create project board for specific work, roadmap, or even release checklist. So give the meaningful project board name. Give the description. Project templates. You can add project board template from drop-down box. These templates are available by default. If you select none, it means that you are going to create project board from the scratch. Next one is basic Kanban. Track your task with to-do, in progress, and done column. Next one is automated Kanban. In automated Kanban, card automatically move between to-do, in progress, and done column. Next one is automated Kanban with reviews. Everything is going to be similar, like automated Kanban plus trigger for pull request reviews. Next and last one is bug triage. In this project board, you can track and prioritize the bug with columns like high, medium, low priority. For this demonstration, I'm selecting done. I'm going to create the project board from the scratch. My project will be public. If you are using the enterprise age GitHub, then you have to create private project. Link repositories. Currently, we haven't created any repository. So leave the blank. Go ahead and create project. Your blank project has been created. Let's create project board. Let's add a column called to do. Everything is going in this column that is planned but not started. Leave the automation none and create column. Let's add one more column called in progress. In this column, everything is going that is actively being worked on but not done or closed. In automation, select the in progress. You can select any of the options. For example, I am selecting reopened. It means that any closed issue in the project reopened, then it is going to automatically move to in progress column. Say create column and let's add one more column called done. You can go for the automation. I am selecting close. If an open issue in this project is closed, it will automatically move here. Go ahead and create a column. Once your project board ready, you can start to discuss with project manager or developer team about the project lifecycle. Let's add couple of the item in to-do list. I created couple of the item in to-do after having a discussion with the project management team and development team. Now we are having a regular discussion with the development team and we are tracking down the progress of each and every item. So we are adding all the tasks that is currently in progress. So we added two items in the progress. Login page deployment has been completed and currently security team is working for the single sign-on. Also, home page design has been approved by the customer. Deployment is in progress. If any of the item or task completed, then it is going to done column. For example, security team completed single sign-on login page, so this task has been completed. You can see overall progress of your project on the top, like 1 done, 2 in progress, 0 to do. You can also archive all cards. If you feel that task has been completed and stable for quite long time and you don't require to display the card here, then you can archive the card. Obviously, you can delete columns, you can copy column link, you can manage automation, etc. Once your project has been completed, you can close anytime, like close project in the activity. You can check all the activities of your project here. Now let's create a repository and link that repository with this project. I am creating a repository called Automobile Web, and this repository is public one. Add readme page and create repository. Repository has been created, but it is not part of any project yet. Let's go ahead and link this repository to the project. Let's go ahead and click on manage organization, click on organization, click on project, click on automobile project, go to menu and click on settings and click on link a repository. Search the repository which you want to link it. Go ahead and link it. Now this repository has been associated with the project. If you click on projects, and you will see automobile project, and this is the link repositories. At this moment, our organization is ready. A project has been created in the organization and one repository has been associated with the project. Next, we require to create a team and add members on this project so that member can access the project repository for their work. So in next video, we are going to discuss how to create teams and add members in it. In this video, that's all. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.